The next section of our textbook covers some selected properties of liquids, and it really highlights on two of them, viscosity and surface tension. So the first is viscosity. And viscosity can be simply defined as the resistance of liquid to flow. And since the liquid kind of resists flow, it's going to depend on how the intermolecular forces and structural factors, which could cause a molecule to become kind of entangled. So if we have large intermolecular forces, we're going to have a really, really high viscosity. Okay, and these intermolecular forces are also going to depend on temperature. So as we increase the temperature, we're going to decrease our viscosity. Because as the temperature increases, the particles move faster. They're not as attracted to each other. So the viscosity here is going to go down. And think of, motor oil. If you have, SAE 40 versus SAE 10, the higher the number, the higher the viscosity, which means it's going to pour slower. Whereas if you have SAE 10, you have a low number, you have a low viscosity, and you're going to have faster pouring. Okay, so they definitely depend on the intermolecular forces. So you have to look into those and be able to identify from our previous video how we could relate the intermolecular forces that we learned to the viscosity. The second is surface tension. And surface tension can be defined as the energy required to increase surface area by a unit amount. So this is your generic textbook definition, but what on earth does that mean? Okay, so if we look into this, we can say the following, that surface molecules experience a net inward force from adjacent molecules. And this force pulls molecules from the surface into the liquid, and as a consequence, this reduces the surface area. So if you have a strong force together, strong intermolecular forces, it's going to require more energy to increase that surface area. So if we look and relate this to intermolecular forces, the higher the intermolecular forces, the higher the surface tension. And these are just two properties that we're going to look at that deal with intermolecular forces and directly relate to them. And in the next video, we're going to look at how these intermolecular forces influence the phases of particular solids, liquids, and gases, and we'll look into something called phase changes.